Well, it is that time of year. Wedding season is in full swing. And Kimberly, do you have a hard time trying to figure out what you're going to buy a friend if they're getting married?
You know, it's really hard because you never know. You think somebody, you know, wants something and then you see it in regifting at Christmas.
It happens all the time. And for the bride and groom, it's a pretty overwhelming task to register for gifts. And for a guest, obviously, you're never really sure what you want to get. But we've got help for you right now. Lifestyle expert Chris Scholes is going to take care of all this. Wedding registries, wedding gifts, the whole nine yards.
I hope I'm here. Chris to the rescue with this, right?
Yeah, for sure.
I wish I had had somebody kind of tell me, take me through the whole process. Because when you're registering, we ended up with 5,000 glasses. Who needs those?
No.
And yet I didn't register for, like, normal things that people need. So,
right. So
we're going to start here. Actually, what I love is exactly what he just said, someone to guide you through it. So Sur La Table, which I've got this fun knife set here, but they actually have a wedding registry concierge service.
Oh, nice.
You can do it all online. And I know, like, my husband was not all about going out to the store, even though if I'd given him that little
scan
gun.
Maybe.
Come on, Jimmy, you're a scan gun kind of person.
I was like, honey, just pick what you want. I don't want to talk about it.
So they'll actually take you through the whole wedding planning process and, like, getting all the things that you need for your first home, which is great. But there's also new services out there now. There's a place called Mercy Registry, and you can register at all different stores. And you can also register for your honeymoon. You can register
in one spot?
In one
spot. That is great.
All
online. Love that.
Yes. You can, you know, get people to pitch in. Heck, they could probably buy you a new car if you wanted them
if they wanted. What are some must-haves? If you're going to be a newlywed, what are the must-haves?
Yes. Must-haves. Luggage. Luggage and travel accessories, because every couple is going to go on a honeymoon.
Right.
So that's something they can use right away. So Lands End has fantastic luggage. I've got things over here. And then also what you don't think about, silliest thing ever, vacuum.
I know. I mean, listen, as
a
woman, I don't want anybody to give me a gift, which is a vacuum or an appliance or anything like that.
But you need it.
When you move, the first thing you realize is, I have nothing to vacuum my coffee with.
I don't have a vacuum. That's
yes,
right.
And if you're going to get a vacuum, get a good one. Like Dyson here, they're a little bit more expensive, but it's not going to break. So just don't cheap out on
the vacuum.
Why
would you register for the cheapest thing at your wedding? Register for the high-end product, right?
And where it counts. So another thing that you absolutely need, coffee pot, crock pot.
Yes.
Crock pot is the most used item in my kitchen. And then, again, if you don't want just a plain appliance, Bella Appliances has all these little matching
sets. It's very trendy. It's kind of cool.
It's funky, fun, right?
And trendy.
Yeah.
Mixer. Stamps. I love the mixer. This is a weird color,
mixer.
Though. This is, I mean,
what
it's a great color.
It's like milkshake.
It's not a bad color. It's just interesting.
That's my favorite color. It's my signature blue, the KitchenAid mixer. But
like
that
it.
Is a must-have. It's got all these different attachments to it. And you can do pasta. I mean, you can do everything. If I did not have that in my kitchen, I would cry.
And it's one of those slightly expensive things that you'd be a little reluctant to buy for yourself.
Yeah.
So again,
let somebody else buy it for
registering,
you.
Registering. What do we have down at this end
we
of the table?
We have down here, if you're going to spend a little bit more money as well, I have to have something that is multifunctional. So it has to multitask. And that's what I love about the Le Creuset items. Mm-hmm. They can go from stovetop to oven. And then they're also pretty enough to put on your table.
I love them.
Because they're in this blue.
Yes.
Chris has a thing for this blue, as you can see.
The blue that you just called weird.
I didn't say it was weird. I said it was weird for a stand mixer. And then last but not least, tell me about this, because this is a way that if you don't want to break the bank, you can do something thoughtful.
If you don't want to break the bank, you can always do a homemade gift basket, especially if you kind of know the couple and want to do something a little more personal. I did like a pasta date night, for example, with a cookbook. It's appreciated. It shows you put a lot of thought into it, and just a really nice thing to do.
Well, it's
for
also a great way to put those little miscellaneous things that you need in the kitchen together in a basket.
Into a basket.
And do some type of basket. That's
and
a
to
good
show
idea.
The year. Chris, thank you so much. Chris
thank
has guided
you.
Us through getting our wedding registry done.